the essential makeup kit. I store my makeup in here, but we are talking all about drugstore. If you're interested in this bag, I do have a video on the whole entire thing. I will link that for you, but that's how I store my makeup kit. How do you guys store your makeup kit? Thank you for stopping by. We are going over the essential drugstore makeup kit. That case was not drugstore, but all of it inside is drugstore. So my aim in this video today was to bring you something that you could walk in to any drugstore. If you want to go Walgreens, Target, Rite Aid, CVS, Walmart, any of those, you could walk in there and find these very easily. And I think that I've achieved that except for one product that I'll show you towards the end.
All right, we're going to go from the very basics all the way to the end look, which is the lips.
We're going to start out with what I use almost every single time I do my makeup, and I love this. This is the e.l.f. Poreless Putty Primer. Today I used the Luminous one. The difference is that it just has a tiny bit of a subtle glow, but it still has those great pore refining effects to it, and it also does a really great job of helping to keep oils at bay and just helping to perfect your makeup and making it last a lot longer. So that is one of my very favorites. The next thing is on the under eyes right here, I have terrible dark circles. And so to counteract those dark circles, I use a color corrector, which is from LA Girl. And this is the Pro Concealer in Peach. This peach is the perfect color to counteract those dark blue circles, purple circles that you have. And it just lays down so well, and it plays so well with other concealer. And then on to foundation, I absolutely love the Revlon ColorStay 24 Hour Foundation. My color is 150 and it is buff. And it is the normal to dry formula, which I love. And it says 24 hours. Nothing lasts for 24 hours, obviously, on me or on most of us, but this is an excellent foundation for lasting a really long time. They also have it in the normal to oily formula, which is really good as well. And I have just heard nothing but good things about this. This finishes my skin so nicely, and it just gives great coverage without looking like a mask. It's what I have on, obviously, today. And I just think this is one of the better ones at the drugstore. And then for concealer in this kit, the Makeup Revolution Infinite Conceal and Define. I think this is such a good product. I really enjoy it. It covers up so well. It almost self-sets, which I think is fantastic when you have really dry and wrinkled under eyes, because you don't have to go in with a powder and make sure it's set. I do that a little bit anyway because I get such bad hot flashes. It has the basic doe foot applicator, and it just really, it's just beautiful. So I really enjoy it a lot.
And I think it's perfect for in anybody's kit, but especially if you have dry, mature under eyes.
All right, next, I feel like these eyeshadows are some next level beauties. I have just absolutely fallen in love with this brand, and it is from LA Girl. And these are their new little palettes. But you guys, if you go back into any of my videos, you'll find that the bigger palettes, the 16 pan ones, are the same exact as these, and I've completely fallen in love with them. And they have such a gorgeous array of colors this time. They have the purple one, I think they have a warm berry one, and then they have a couple other ones that I don't have out of this, but they're so great. And this is the one that I have on today. They are just absolutely beautiful formula, wonderful for any kit. So if you see any of these that you're really interested in and you want to just take the plunge on those, go ahead and pick those up. And then I also want to express that I really love the e.l.f. their huge palettes that are the 18 pan palettes. Think they are so good. They have the new neutrals one, which I just think is just a fabulous color scheme for anybody that, the new classics, excuse me, for anybody that loves just a very neutral eye, or a very, you know, just everyday neutral eye. And then this one is Earth and Ocean, which I do have in a tutorial, I believe, somewhere. And I will make sure that I link that one for you too. But if you wanted to get these and then supplement them with the little $3 bite ones, these are fantastic. Or if you just wanted to go for the little bite ones, they are so good. And they have just a beautiful color story in each of them that you're able to go ahead and, you know, supplement any of these that you wanted to with it. But the LA Girl formula is so outstanding, and I really want to reiterate that it is just a beautiful formula that I've talked about so many times on my channel. And for a makeup kit, and whether you're starting out or whether you just want to add to it, just such fantastic formula. Next is from Laura
L'Oreal, and this is my bronzer slash contour, and I used it today as both. This is a great big huge pan. This is the light one. It does have a subtle glow to it. It's not a lot, as you can see on my face. I've used it to, you know, outline my whole face, or, you know, carve out those cheekbones, the high forehead, and then the gels down here. And then I've kind of just dusted it over as the bronzing. The light one has this great quality of not having too much of the orange in it, or too much of that golden color in it. And I love that about it, because I am able to really get in there with that contour and still have it look like a contour, instead of just looking like, you know, you've put orange over there in your contour area. So I really do love this. It blends in super silky and super easy, and it just helps complete the look and make the look so polished. And I would recommend that in anybody's kit. What you're gonna see right now is that I went in with my highlight before I did my blush, and I love the ColourPop Super Shock formula of highlights. This is such a good formula. I have three different ones, and I'm going to show them all to you for different reasons. The first one is Stole the Show. Stole the Show is kind of just a lighter, brighter white almost looking highlight. Such a beautiful highlight. And then the second one is Smoke and Whistles. This is like a pink highlight, or has a pink cast to it. All of these, when they get on your skin, they're not going to really show that much of a cast to them. But the last one that I want to show you is the one that I have on, and this is Flexitarian. And this one has just a little tiny bit of that gold look to it. So there's the three of them, just subtle differences in all three of them. And my goodness, what a difference it makes across your skin. There's no texture, there's no glitter, there's just absolutely gorgeous shine. And you can see how that just sets off that look completely on mine. And then I took Flexitarian and I went into my inner corner today too. So I really, really love this so much. And then for blush, when I was talking about the essential kit, I had to put in the Milani baked blushes. I have four colors that I rotate through. They're really good blushes, almost like they have a primer in them. And then they're also wonderful blushes as far as having that subtle luminosity that just makes aging skin just brighten up. And I think they're so gorgeous. This one is Dolce Pink, and this is probably the pinkest one out of them all, but it just goes on so pretty, gives that little bit of luminescence shine. And I just think they're absolutely gorgeous. And I will make sure I list all four of these colors down below. Love those. And then I went in with the Milani Stay Put Liner, and this one is in Cobalt, and I love this, and it's the one that is right there on my hand. I just went in on the outer quarter right there and then smudged it out, and then I went in with the Acacia U, or Acacia U, I'm not exactly sure which one it is, on the e.l.f., and I just took this color, actually this color right here, and I just smudged it into it so that it can be bulletproof. But this is a waterproof supposedly too, so you should be able to get some really good wear out of that if you just smudged it, as compared to putting this on top of it. But if you do that, you're bulletproof. I went into the brows with the e.l.f. Wow Brow. I've spoken about this so much lately. Sorry about the girls there. Doggy death match over there. This is a little tiny bristle brush that goes into those hairs and grabs onto them so great, and it's just absolutely gorgeous. It is what I use 100%. I don't use anything else on my brows anymore. And it just holds them in place, but it has little fibers in it and it builds up. So if you have sparse brows, but you like the shape okay, you can go in. You can change the shape some, because I don't have brows that look like this in the normal, but this product really builds up. It really helps it so much, and it just makes my brows look like fluffy brows instead of just tiny little lines across my eyes. Now, if you're somebody that does like the penciled in look, from Wet n Wild, I really like this one. I don't know if you're gonna be able to see this or not. I don't use this one very often now that I found the other from e.l.f., but this is a great one. It's kind of in a triangular shape there. So as you're doing it, you get the, you know, the little precise strokes to it. And then on the other side, it does have a spoolie. So this is really great. There went Ollie. This is really great. And you will probably have to use some sort of a setting gel. You can buy e.l.f. setting gel if you want to, but they're really good products, both of them. Love them. From number seven is what I set my face with today. This looks like such a high-end product, and I absolutely love this. It is The powder inside, I've said it over and over again, it's a dupe for Charlotte Tilbury.
But this is every bit as good, if not better, for me. I just love how blurring this is and how beautiful it looks on my skin. I love that this packaging looks so luxe and it's so pretty. I love that there's not a high price tag with it. And I love that it doesn't really accentuate any fine lines or any dryness for me as a mature woman. So I am absolutely in love with that powder. Has to be in your kit. And then also from Milani is another powder that I would recommend to you as a finishing powder. Finishing powders are nice to go in after you have that setting powder, or even after you've done your setting spray, you can go in with this and you get that subtle glow or that beautiful glow to your skin. And I just think it's such a good powder to have on hand. This is my second one of these. And for me to say that this is my second one and it has a huge dividend in it already is really a big deal, because I test out so many different products, so many different brands all the time for you guys. And this one is something that is in my makeup kit, never goes anywhere. I absolutely love it. All right, next in line is from NYX, and this is the liner that I have on my top lash line. And this is the Epic Ink Liner. It's a great pen ink liner. It makes the most beautiful little lines. I mean, you can do tiny lines, you can do thicker lines, whatever you want to do. And it is just a beautiful product for coming out steady. It lasts a long time. It stays on until you take it off at night. I just think it's such a great product. And then lastly, for the eyes, I did the Falsies mascara. I love this mascara. This is the waterproof formula on the lash lift, and I do like this. It's got that subtle hourglass on it. I've talked about this so much, so I felt like I really wanted to put it in the makeup kit that I was getting together at the drugstore. But I also recently found from L'Oreal, this is their new Air Volume Mega Mascara, and it is what I have on today. And this is like a new love for me. I am in love with it because it really separates and gives volume, but it adds a lot of length at the same time, and it lasts. I have been really surprised. I've even tried it on my bottom lash line today, which there's no smudging, no flaking, and that is what happens at the end of the day. It's super easy to take off because it's not waterproof, but it is still there. There's hardly any flaking on it. I wanted to make sure I mentioned it as far as putting it into a makeup kit, because I think this is going to be a fabulous, fabulous mascara for everyone as far as it feeling really soft on the lashes. I mean, my lashes are touchable. Don't feel hard like lashes can do with a waterproof mascara, but I do love my Falsies from Maybelline as well. For a setting spray, this is the product that I was talking about that you can't really find very easily at the drugstore, although you can order this at Ulta.com. And so I wanted to make sure I said it, because honestly, this is what lives in my makeup kit. This is what I use all the time. Two things. I love that it's the hydrating setting spray from them. I think that's fantastic. It doesn't dry me out during the winter. I can use it all year round, and I feel like I'm not melting in the summer, but in the winter, I feel like I have that extra dose of hydration. The other thing that is absolutely lovely about this product is its spray. Its spray is super fine. It's not going to spit at you. It's not going to squirt at you. So you're not going to have to go back in with your sponge afterwards and take off any of those dots or that spit at you that you've had. I love these. Any of them that you choose. If you're an oily skin gal, the regular setting spray. They also recently came out with the glow formula that is beautiful to give you that natural glow as well. I love these sprays. I think they're next level beautiful. They had to be in the kit. You can find these at Kroger stores. So if you have a Fred Meyer, a Smith's Marketplace, or Kroger stores, and I'm sure there's others in that family, they do sell this at the marketplace ones, the bigger ones. So just so you know, love this. It had to be in my makeup kit. And then lastly, the lip products. This is from Essence. This is their lip liner. This is Sucker for Grace, and I think it's called their Soft Contouring. The reason that I love this color is not just because it's mauve. I like it because it's cool toned. And what that does, I've been using it so much, and I feel like it's really done a great thing for my lips, in that it gives that soft contour to the lips, but it's super blendable with lipsticks, and it still looks like it's a making your pout bigger because you can outline a little bit because it is on that gray side. So this has been like so good for me to have. And then any of the Maybelline lipsticks that you want to try. Mine's in Blushing Pout today. This is my favorite. I've talked about it ad nauseum on my channel, but it's this vibrant deep blue pink, and I absolutely love it. I'll go ahead and just put a little bit more on right now.
Oh, so pretty. Love it. Plays well with that liner. It plays well with lip glosses. It's wonderful. And then I'm sorry, but I had to mention two lip glosses from Essence. This is their Plumping Nude ones. This one is the clear formula, so it's going to go on any lipstick, make you look like you've got a juicy, yummy pout, and it just is fantastic. It lasts a long time, not too sticky. Really, really like that. But I absolutely am a huge lover of the NYX Butter Glosses. These have to be in anybody's kit. I think I have like 8 different colors. This one is called Cinnamon. This is my latest Cinnamon Bun, I think, something with Cinnamon Roll maybe. I don't know, but it's my latest one in my lineup of them. It gives color, but it's not so much color that the gloss is going to run color all over. And it just makes your lips look so healthy and nice. And I love that the color is there. So if you don't want to use a lipstick, if you're on the move one day, you can just go across your lips. It wears off so evenly and it just lasts for at least a couple hours if I'm not eating, drinking, anything like that. So I had to mention two of these. All right, that's it. That is everything in this makeup kit. I hope that you guys did enjoy seeing this. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. Thanks so much for being with me today. You guys know how much I appreciate that. Hope everybody is doing really well. Take care of yourselves, and I'll catch you in my next video. Love you much. Bye-bye.